Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I've decided to make an oak pendant shaped like an acorn. My mom had seen an oak box that I had turned a few months ago, and she decided she wanted one for a pendant. So, here I am. I'm just using the skew. Take out a few of the bumps and ridges on this piece of branch that I had taken off one of my trees in the front yard. It was a dead branch. I don't take live ones, if at all possible. So it was about this point that I realized I should have turned the top before drilling out the center for the bottom. So what I did, I turned the piece around and turned the top instead. If the piece looks shorter, it actually is because there was a big knot in the other end of the branch. So I just cut it off and I'm using what's available. So here I'm sanding. I start at about 180 and I sand it right up to 600 grit. Then I use an abrasive paste that I had made and a polishing paste. And it brings up the shine really nice. So here I'm just trying the cap on, bringing down the end to fit the cap. I've marked the inside depth on the outside. It doesn't leave me much room for turning the bottom, but I actually bring the piece of stock out a little bit on the chuck. I didn't tighten the chuck really tight because I didn't want to bend the tips of it. So I'm being very careful here. I don't recommend to anybody to be cutting this close to the edge of the chuck. So before I finish shaping the bottom, I sand it again right up to a 600 grit and use the polishing paste again. As you can see, I brought the stock of wood right out to the tips of the chuck. It's not in there very tight. So that's why I brought the tail stock up to make sure it didn't come flying out. And it seemed to work very carefully. I brought it down and got it to where I wanted it. And here I'm just using my Dremel to smooth out the end. So this was definitely not the best way to make one of these acorn boxes. There are definitely better videos out there by other people. And I will probably make one again in the future, maybe just a little bigger. And maybe another video. You never know. So here's the final piece. I put it on a cord, put a wire through it, and the wire is on the inside, as you can see. Pop the lid off. You can store a little trinket or something in there, maybe some sage or sweetgrass. There you go. It's about 1.5 inches long, so it can be worn on a necklace. If you like what you see, don't forget to like and subscribe and comment. Let me know what you think. See you next week.